What's up, guys? Tom here. Welcome back to another video. Today, I want to show you how to add some life and some feel to your programmed MIDI drums with the use of ghost notes and a couple other little tricks too. All right, so we're in Logic and I've got a software instrument track pulled up already. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Y to just bring up my sort of menu over here. Select a drum kit. Let's go with Brooklyn because why not? Hit Y to get rid of that. I've already set my tempo to 80 BPM because that's kind of where I want to work for this groove that I have in my head to just use it as an example. So let's hit R, record something, and we'll go from there. Very simple groove. So I'm going to select my region. I'm going to hit C to cycle through this to make sure it repeats. Hit P to bring up piano roll. And I'm gonna select all and then go to 16th note quantization. Rigid, lifeless. A couple other things to just sort of get to even here. I'm gonna go to fixed velocity. I hit Command 9 to open up this window, by the way. Command 9 to open up my MIDI editor window. I'm gonna go to fixed velocity in the drop-down menu here. And it's at 100 by default, operate only. Command W to close that. Again, dull, lifeless, but it is a groove. Now I'm gonna take all my snare notes here and I'm going to pull them to 120. My OCD likes it. And also when I start dragging them around, they won't overlap each other. I just wanna make sure they're nice and short. So I got my snare center here. Now here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna take the snare center and I'm gonna drag it up to snare rim shot for my backbeat on 2 and 4. Then I'm gonna hold Command, I'm gonna drag them around a little bit, come back down to the snare center, I'm gonna add one there, and I'm gonna add one there, and then I'm gonna get rid of that guy, and I'm gonna pull this guy right back here to 121, and I'm gonna make sure it's quantized to 32nd notes. And then we'll pull this region back, and let's see what we got here. So, a little bit better. We got some ghost notes, but it's the guitar center groove. It's super lifeless, super emotionless, and it's what you hear people practicing who aren't very good at drums on the kits at Guitar Center. So, let's add some life to it. So, I'm going to hit A for the automation window, and I'm going to select just the snare center track. I'm going to bring these way down to like 55-ish. And I hear the difference already. I'm gonna bring it down a little bit more because the point of the ghost notes is to be almost more felt than audibly heard. Just adds a little bit of syncopation to give that beat some forward momentum. And now what we're gonna do, let's add a little bit of life to the hi-hat. I'm gonna select every second note here. Every offbeat eighth note. I'm going to pull up automation again. I'm going to pull these down. If we're at 100 on the 1 and 3, I'm going to pull it down to 80-ish. So now we've got that tat, 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 that sort of driving quarter note feel thing that keeps it kind of loose and groovy. And then, didn't mean to do that. Get rid of automation one more time. And the last thing I want to do is I want to add a couple of ghost notes on the kick drum here. So I'm going to add one there. I'm going to add one here. I'm going to select both of those, move them down to the second kick track. That way I can select them all at one time. Easy peasy. Keep hitting that. And then I'm going to hit A for automation again. You can see why hotkeys are important. Also, just so you know, you can click this little button right here to show or hide automation. I just like hotkeys, it makes life a lot easier. I'm gonna bring this kick drum down to around 55.2. Still too hot. I wanna bring it down even more. I'm gonna come down to like 30 something. There we go. Now we got something going. And then The last thing I want to do, this is the cool trick right here. I'm going to select my kick drum, and I'm going to pull up the MIDI automation window one more time. Now that we've got, let's just listen to our groove one more time. Now that we've got some life and feel in the ghost notes and the velocities, now we can add some movement back and forth around the click track to give it more humanity, if you will. So this is our groove right now, completely gridded to the click. We've already come like miles ahead of where we were with that rigid beat to begin with, right? This already has a ton of life to it, but we can still do more. So again, select the kick track, command 9 to bring this up, and I'm going to go to this drop-down menu. I'm going to go to humanize. And what this does is it adds randomness to the notes. You can humanize the entire thing. You can humanize certain parts of it. Here's what I like to do. I like to go for velocity. I like to go about 5 randomness. Since we've already switched things up a little bit and we've adjusted our velocities where we want them, this isn't quite as important, but you do want to add a little bit of flavor to it. So we'll go 5 there. On length, length doesn't particularly matter with drums because it's one strike anyway. So I'll just leave it at that or set it to 0. It really doesn't matter. And then position. This is the big one. You don't want to go random. You want to go add. You want to go to add. And what this does is if this is your bar line, this adds the specified number to the number of ticks that your note will fall behind the bar line. So if you want to give yourself a fat kick drum, like if you're doing hip hop or soul or funk, something like that, or even EDM, man, if you want to give it more pocket, add a little bit to that. So I'm going to go with just 10. 10 can actually make a lot of difference. A little goes a long way with this. So I'm going to add 10, and let's zoom in on the very first kick drum here so you can see what happens. So here's our bar line. When I hit operate, you see how it jumps back just a little bit. Just a little bit will add a ton. So I'm going to zoom back out. I'm going to do it to the hi-hat as well. Again, we'll zoom in so you can see what happens. Operate only. All right, now I'm going to close this window here. And now let's listen to our groove. It's not a lot, but it's just enough to provide that pocket and that feel that makes it feel like a really good drummer is playing this part. And just for argument's sake, if you're not hearing that difference, let me exaggerate it a lot and show you what that does. So let's just add another, we're already 10 behind, so let's add another 20 to the kick drum. And do you see it pop over? Now let's listen. You hear how fat that is, how far back in the pocket that is? That's like some funk drumming right there. So this kind of thing is actually super rad in hip hop. If you want to add, like, take your bass line and your kick drum and lay them back for that super slow groove, like that kind of thing. And if you want to do like the old school hip hop feel where it's, you got like a live drum kit, like the Questlove thing and like a funky bass line, this kind of groove is amazing for that. And you can switch up all kinds of different things in here with the ghost notes and where your ghost notes are placed depending on your groove. There are a lot of different kind of grooves, obviously, so put your ghost notes in interesting places, but always think about them as subdivisions on the offbeat. So if you've got a tempo of 80, those are your 16th notes, you want them on that left hand kind of every time, because the point of them is to subtly add a little bit of momentum and movement and syncopation to your track so that you get that forward feel, but you can also pull it back and give it kind of a fatness at the same time. So that's what this is great for. I think you'll be surprised at how lifelike you can get your fake drums to sound doing this. Even just stock stuff in Logic. Don't feel like you have to go out and buy a ton of plugins when you have every tool at your disposal just already in your DAW. So If there's anything else that you want to hear me kind of do this thing on, if you want to learn something, if there's anything you would like for me to share or break down like this, let me know in the comments section. I want to do a ton more of these videos. I really enjoy them. I like doing them. And just think of me as your human guinea pig. I will, even if I don't know how to do it, I'll learn how to do it and then I'll reteach. So yeah, that's it for today. Thanks for watching and I will catch you next time. Peace.